Well, welcome to this video. In this video, we discuss CHSH game. So let's quickly recap what CHSH inequality was. So suppose PQRS are four random variables that can take discrete values -1 or +1. Then we define a new random variable in this particular combination of these four, and it takes a value -2 or +2. And this is in EPR sense, where these are treated as random variables that will either be -1 or +1 deterministically. So because you see, in quantum mechanics, if we perform measurement about one axis, it affects the other axis, and so there is no fact that this axis is independent of this axis, and the outcomes of both axes are determined. But in this case, these random variables, we say if their outcomes is determined, then this C variable, its expectation value will always be <= 2. But we saw that in quantum mechanics that can be violated. And what is correct to say in quantum mechanics is that this it is always <2√2, where this maximum upper bound is reached by the singlet state psi. And with this understanding, we start with the setup of a game. So the game is that there is a referee, and there are two players, Alice and Bob, two parties. They might have come together in some past event, and they are sharing presently a correlated bit, which can have classical correlations, quantum correlations, all those. And the referee randomly provides Alice with some questions A, and to which Alice has to give a response X, and it provides Bob with some questions B, and to which Bob has to give a response Y. And these responses can be just a 0-1, that means a true false response or yes no. And Alice and Bob, they wins if the referee evaluates and sees that this particular constraint is satisfied. So what this means is that the product of the referee's inputs should be the XOR or the mod 2 operation of the Alice and Bob's output. So for example, if referee gives 1 and 0, 1 to Alice and 0 to Bob, then the product is 0. And in this case, either both Alice and Bob agrees, like if they both give a same outcome, like if they both say it is 0, or if they both say this is 1, then only this can be matched 0=0. So that is the main point. More precisely, A, B, X, Y are variables that takes value 0 and 1. But remember, this is not -1, 1, as it was the case for this CHSH inequality to apply. So this is the case, and A and B can take value 0, 1, that essentially means A and B is 0, 1, 0 is also 0, 1, 1 is 1, and 0, 0 is also 0. So we see 3 out of the 4 times we get 0, and whenever we get 0 for A and B, Alice and Bob, they can choose same answer, that is either both give XY 0 or both give XY 1. And they will win for this. So that means 3 out of the 4 times, if they decide to give same answer, they will win. And this indeed is the maximum classical probability of their winning, as we will soon see. So given this is the setup, where Alice Bob gets outputs, inputs in form of 0, 1 bits, and they they provide outputs in form of 0-1 bit. So to apply this CHSH inequality, we have to reframe this entire discussion so that we essentially get variables like PQRS, which takes minus 1, 1 value. So let's try to define this then. So we define a new probability that is essentially the probability that we want to calculate in one form. That will soon become clear. So define P A comma B as the winning probability, as the winning probability for the inputs AB. So P01 means probability of winning the game given the inputs were 0 and 1. Yeah, and the second definition that we do is that we basically classify Alice and Bob's outputs based on their inputs. So classify X, which is Alice's output, such that when Alice gets an input 0, I just call it X0. And if she gets an input 1, I call it X1. So this is nothing but a redefinition of X, where I am becoming more clear about what this input is and what this output is. This X0, X1, Y0, Y1, these all are variables that will take 0 or 1 value, but I have just separated them based on their inputs. So with this understanding we have done, we can now define these PQRS, the variables that we can use in our CHSH inequality in this particular fashion, because these X0, X1, Y0, Y1, they take value 0 and 1, PQRS now takes value minus 1 and 1. So now all that is left is to calculate the expectations of PQRS and then add them to get this expectation of C and compare our classical and quantum results. So let us perform that quickly. So expectation of PR is basically P times R, this random variable, its expectation value. But now you can see that this random variable, because I have X0 and Y0, this means the input for Alice is 0 and input for Bob is also 0, and this entire random variable can take value plus 1 or minus 1, and whenever Alice and Bob, they both will win. So for input 0, 0, Alice and Bob will win whenever they answer same. And whenever they answer same, either X0 will either be 0 or and Y0 also 0, or both 1, 1. In this case, this entire thing will always take the value plus 1. So the expectation value is plus 1 times the probability of getting plus 1. That is the probability when they both will win. And that is what I have written here, that is P00. And then plus minus 1, that is another expectation value, times the probability of getting minus 1 is when they lose. And that gives us this particular value. And similarly, we can do one more. So suppose we do this this last one, suppose that is QS is expectation of this particular thing. Again, this particular thing can take value plus 1 or minus 1, but as I have X1 and Y1, essentially my inputs are 1 and 1, so I have fixed my inputs to be 1 and 1. And now if both Alice and Bob wins, so for input 1 and 1, so for input 1 and 1, 1 and 1 is just 1, and they will win if they give a different answer, either 0 XOR 1 or 1 XOR 0. But whenever they win, this variable is picking up a minus 1 sign. That means minus 1 times probability that they win for input 1 and 1 plus 1 times 1 minus probability, that means they lose. So similarly, each of these 4 expectation value can be calculated, and then we add these 3 values 1, 2, 3 and subtract the 4th one so as to get this particular expectation value, and I have done that here. So as we can see, this is the CHSH inequality, and I will just plug in the 4 things that I have obtained there. And the inequality can be recasted like this, where only the probabilities are on the left side. Now, what is this telling us? You see, what is the probability of Alice getting input 0 and Bob getting input 0? It is 1 by 2 times 1 by 2. Of course, if the referee has been choosing the questions randomly. For example, referee chooses Alice's question randomly as well as Bob's question randomly, then probability of getting the 0 is simply half, right? Because A can be either 0 or 1. So this gives us 1 by 4 times P00 as the probability of winning the game given the inputs are 0, 0. This is probability of winning the game given the inputs are 0, 1. Similarly, this and this. So the entire thing on the left side is the probability of winning the game, and that is upper bounded by 3 by 4. That is almost 0.75. But this upper bound came from CHSH game. That means in CHSH game, or if Alice and Bob they share only classical bits, they can maximum win with a probability of 3 by 4. That is obviously when they both always keep on giving the same answer, either 0, 0 or 1, 1, in which case they will only lose for the a case when referee gives the input A equal to B equal to 1. But in presence of entangled bits or quantum correlation, this is the CHSH where this maxima can be hit by the singlet state, and then the probability of winning is this particular value, that is almost 0.85. So there is a gain in winning by using entangled bits as a resource. So that's all for this video. In this video, we talked about this CHSH game, which is useful for discussing various other non-local games. So that's all.